Been to Shmoocon before. What do we do now? Rock, paper, scissors. All right, so here's the deal. Now, I got to give a little bit of backstory. First of all, we're going to try to be relatively expeditious about the closing ceremonies because we all know you want to get home. Also,
I want to get home.
And she wants to get home, and I'll talk forever if you give me the opportunity. But I do have to give some backstories. We used to throw things out to you, and books, which are kind of weapons when you do that, and T-shirts. And then things started to happen, like we, maybe at the Marriott might have broke part of a chandelier.
And at the Hyatt.
So Hilton, so far we haven't broken anything, so we're trying to continue that, because if those lights come down, that will be a catastrophic failure. So yeah, all the people there are like, I'm going to move my seat now. So instead of throwing things, what we're going to do is we're going to play rock, paper, scissors. Now, it's interesting because the world championship for the game of rock, paper, scissors is actually only a few hundred people. And we could have the world record if we had like someone here from Guinness to take all your names and stuff, but we don't. So we're just going to personally know that this is actually the world's largest rock, paper, scissors contest. But you just have to, know it in your heart, not know it on a piece of paper kind of thing. Much like my college degree. So... there's about a dozen-ish books, so we're going to, how many? 16 is a dozen-ish books, and so what we're going to do, and just listen to the directions, don't do anything until I tell you to. We're all going to stand up, and you're going to find a partner, and on the count of three, meaning one, two, and on three, not after three, okay, just so we're clear, one, two, three is when you're going to do it. You're going to do rock, paper, scissors, shoot, and you continue that until there's a winner. The loser then sits down. Don't wait for me to tell you. Just sit down, and then don't do anything else, right? And then I'll tell you, find another partner, and then you play. And obviously, this is like a bubble sort, right? We're just going to do, whittle our way down until there's a reasonably small number of people, and then we'll bring you up front, and we'll give you some prizes. Yeah, it's wee. It's all of Bruce's sounds in one place. It's an album.
You should watch him cook dinner.
Yeah, dinner. You should watch me do anything, really. It's pretty exciting. I just went to the bathroom with this. I didn't even think about the irony of it. I came out, some dude's looking at me like, oh, it's fixed. All right, everybody stand up and find a partner. Introduce yourself, make up a name. All right. On the count of three. One, two, three. Losers, sit down.
Both lose.
You cannot both lose and you can't both win. We just saw both of those things happen. All right. Now the winners, find another person. Ready? Ready? Find another person. Don't do it yet. Find another person. On the count of three, 3, 2, 1.
Now you screwed them up. You counted differently.
I hacked the system. All right. So we should have about a quarter of the people standing up now. Looks like we got about a tenth. I don't know what the hell happened, but.
One more time.
Everybody find a partner. Everybody find a partner. Get ready. I'll go the right directions. 1, 2, 3. All right, losers, sit down. Let's see how many winners we got. It's a lot of winners. All right. Everybody, we're going to do this one more time. Find someone. You got 5 seconds. Find them. I hear the melodica. It's awesome. All right, one more time. 1, 2, 3. Winners, come up front. Losers, sit down. If it's a tie, you do it till there's a winner. Have you ever played rock, paper, scissors, sir? Jesus. All right, first of all, we'd like to thank No Stripes Press for all the books. Thanks to Bill and his crew for donating a bunch of books. This looks like a 2 dozen instead of 1 dozen, which is not 16 either way you slice it. So everybody turn to your, side. Find a partner. Scott, you cannot get out of this. You have to find a partner. 32. Oh, he's like, I'm not cheating. No, not me. All right. On the count of three, ready? 1, 2, 3. Losers sit down, winners get books. Thank you, No Starch Press. We really appreciate it.
Do we have an
If we don't have enough, we're going to give away other crap.
I counted 32 people, so we should.
One book.
One book. Not all of them, sir. Just one. Okay. He's like, I got 16 books. Oh, so I can go on. Woo. Okay. That was another sound effect. So that's like five. Are we ready? We're good. So the next thing we're going to do throughout all these talks, or whatever we're about to do, we're going to do a sponsor contest as well. So the sponsors, if you are the winner of a sponsor contest, the sponsors aren't going to come up here. They're going to be over there, and you're going to have to go find them to go get your prize, okay? If you're not in attendance, it's okay. They'll mail it to you, except in one case, you have to be present to attend or win or whatever. So we'll tell you that one when it gets there. But for the most part, if you won, go see the sponsors over there. Cool? Where are the sponsors? Over there. Thank you. Appreciate it. All right. Yes?
No, I didn't.
Okay. Just so you know, we had 2,047 people show up, so we only had 70 folks not make it.
And just a small data point on that, if you were at the own the con yesterday when I gave the numbers of how many people were checked in, that was actually a lie. We hadn't actually checked in any of the staff. So whatever number I said yesterday, you can boost that by 90. So we were probably above 90% checked in by 1:30 yesterday.
Yeah. So good times. And for those that don't know, at the peak of registration in the first push, there weren't actually as many people in line in the very beginning as normal, which is good. Congratulations on not standing in line. It was about one attendee every 3 seconds that we registered. So it's a fairly fast process that works pretty well. Woo, yeah, thanks to the registration team for carrying that off. Sure. Badge contest. This is where I switch.
Yeah,
I'll let you do that.
Yeah. Okay, I know what I'm doing.
Everyone can see your computer.
I know, I only have 3 things open on my computer and they are all good.
No more. Yeah. I don't think we have enough stuff.
Oh wait, that's not right. Is that right? Am I good? Did I do it?
Yeah. Okay, we ran the badge contest. We have a lot of slides, so we'll get through them quick. What?
It's not up? I didn't hit slideshow. I hit fill screen. Right
this here. Happened last year.
Yeah, I know. Right
here. Don't do auto.
It's still not. There's still no slides.
Step away.
How are you doing blind?
No, I can't. Right. I can't do them blind.
What just happened? What'd you do?
This is what you get for $150, all right? Whoa.
It's not that one, is it?
No, the green one.
I have to be on the Shmoo ball defense. All right.
It's the other one.
Oh, man, not again. All right. Well, thanks for G-Mark and Darth for doing this. Here's the Shmoocon, or the Smootrish. Yeah, it did it last year, too. So here's the Build-It thing. We have a whole bunch of different stuff. There's some pictures of people that did the little Pac-Man stuff. Think quick. These are the quick set keys. Now turnkey, ADFG, X Cipher. We have a Pac-Man and everything like that. There's Heidi getting hit with a Shmoo ball. This stuff, don't use Rumpkin. You told me to go fast. So get cracking. There's some MD5 hashes. You just break them, and you get a little tap code there. You decipher that. The total control, all of those things are... You guys can look at that on the website. This actually just goes to a data matrix code. You get these VI commands to go through the punch card, punch it all out. Then you get what is the most auctioned and low item in Shmoocon history. The answer is the Stargate. System is down. Now we're on the badges. If you actually read those straight down, okay, we're actually going to have to slow down here. So
this is the important part.
So if we read down the badges, we get great. Now use this again and find and read the bits. If you go to the website or if you go to those URLs, you'll get all these bits. You read those down and it says, hey, listen, it's dangerous to go alone. Take this. And there's a key looking thing just with the bits. You concatenate all that together to get a big long key, 35 bits. You take that and you use the 6th badge. You find that hex string. You XOR it all together, and you say, congratulations, the test is now over, or am I just pulling you a chain? That's sort of a little portal joke, and then pulling a chain goes onto a block cipher. We go there, we use cake, and you just sort of chain through it. You say, don't go in circles, follow directions, start here, / Lost Woods. You go to Lost Woods, you find all of these things, which are just directions. However, it's a semaphore cipher. The name of this puzzle was Mutex, as a little hint. So you go through there, those are the semaphore flags. It says reverse, skip 5, rot 7, add half to half. So the next thing is this weird ciphertext. You just plug it and just keep going. You just reverse it, skip every fifth letter, rotate by 7, add half to half. You say don't leave home without, and then this weird nasty string. You plug that into this Huffman tree. You decipher the bitstream. You say use the hints to proceed, the key is here, and the way is a square. That's mass transportation or a polybus cipher. You know, we're trying to hint, all right. You only get one time to face your final challenge / LOL. So this was a really bad, very time consuming here. One time pad, face, emojis. You were faced with this as the key and that as the ciphertext. You decipher them all, you figure out the hex. You XOR them with each other, and you get, you're the hero, Shmoocon. Finally, peace returns to the Hilton. This ends the story. The grand prize was Pikachu Mafia, so if they can come on up right now, they're going to win the 3 tickets next year. Also, Decipher was 2nd place, and RBI Sec was 3rd place.
How many people are that?
Well, I think Decipher had like 1 million people, but RBI Sec might be 3. Pikachu Mafia is only 3 or 4. I think some people have already left. There's only 3 coming up now. But Decipher, if however many people you have, I think there might be enough things up here. You guys can come on up, and so with RPISec if they're here.
They get the coveted.
Yay, good job!
Good job, guys.
Yeah. All right, pretty good?
Cool, yeah, awesome. Thanks, guys. Thanks to the badge contest organizers for putting that on. They've done a great job. Yay, badge contest. Woo! I love the explanations of the badge contest. A lot of cons do these challenges. And they're like, and at this step, you just, and invariably it's not like a just, like it's simple, like it's like opening a door. It's like, oh, you just rotate this thing around, you flip it on its head, you convert it to EPSIDIC, and then, you know, and then you have to send it through Morse code, and everything works out. You're like, oh, that was obvious. I mean, duh, like, of course. All right. I don't know what I'm doing.
I don't know what you're doing either. I couldn't have planned that better if I tried. You don't understand. Every year they bring me all these slides, and I'm like, oh, my God, you got to talk fast. We got to get out of here. I want to go home. So that was brilliant. Woo. Oh, another.
Call. All right. For the MITRE contest, thanks to MITRE for having a great contest this year. Woo.
They won something. They did something.
Sheriff Sparks won something. If you're Sheriff Sparks or you want to pretend to be, you can go over and talk to MITRE, and they'll give you your prize, I think. Next up, barcode. How many people entered? Actually, they'll tell you. Never mind. Keep your hands down. It's a secret. You ready?
Yep.
Okay. Forgotten's ready.
Ha ha! That's funny.
That's okay. Yeah, I did forget. I screwed up my own Twitter handle in the slide. So, doing great so far. So, DA and I both took over barcode, Shmoocon. And this year we had the most entries so far, 27 entries. Wow. 19 of them scanned. Contrast is a thing, and yeah. Shiny screens don't work so well. Unfortunately, nobody took our hint that, hey, take a look at what games we like. Mine's a little harder to find. If you can't find DA's favorite game, you should probably check out Twitter and see like half the posts on all of Twitter are XCOM related from DA. So our 3 winners, Arganium, which made a custom version similar to Hack Fortress. And there's the link to the full code so you can play it yourself. Requires co-op play between 2 people and a legit copy of Doom 2. So that was fun.
A copy of Doom 2?
Well,
you know.
Yeah, I mean, if you don't own one, seriously, you should buy one, so it's fine, or acquire one. eBay. I the gentleman who made it offered to possibly help out some folks if you can't find the time and money to buy the best game of all time, his words. Yeah, so he put the code online so anybody can play, write their own challenges, have fun with that. Add stuff. Shmoo ZCT, if anyone remembers ZCT from 1991, little bit older, kind of, but yeah, custom level with a monkey puking on your QR code. Getting there. Okay. 1 second. And then The Legend of Shmoocon by Tess. So pictures, this is actually the level in ZZT once you've beaten the entire level and cleaned up the monkey puke from on top of the QR code to make it not obfuscated. It is on the floppy, and the link to play that online is there. And then this was a hand-drawn Legend of Shmoocon, Legend of Zelda poster that was made by Tess, which was awesome. Thank you for everyone who played, and we will have all pictures and descriptions and links to write-ups on the website. If you look at the bottom of the Shmoo Barcode Shmarcode page, there is a link to the website with pictures and descriptions of everything from all the years I can find. Thank you for everyone who played. Hope you play next year.
Thank you, Forgotten and DA, for putting that on. That's awesome. Also, I heard Computer Land's going to have a sale on video games later if anybody wants to go. Yeah, anyway. Ha ha! Yeah, some of you are old enough. The other people are like, yeah, anyway. KeyW had a contest. It was the tank driving thing. The winner is Drew in all caps.
I actually think Bill tied him, but...
Yeah, the CEO of KeyW actually had the high score, but that seems a little disingenuous to give yourself the prize. So instead, Drew wins. So KeyW's over there, and you can see them. DCSS scanning. Some of you actually probably born after the DCSS case. So, yeah, seriously, like that was like, what, 16 years ago? It was a bit ago. For those that don't know what that was the whole, like, do I have the right to decrypt my DVDs thing and DCSS to take out the CSS protections on DVDs. So we're scanning in some of the legal documents associated with that court case. So we got our act together this year. It was organized, and the machines worked for the most part. And we got over 2,500 pages scanned, so about 10 hours worth of work. And a little bit more of the history of the world is getting put online so that we'll have it forever. So. Good. Warcaller had a contest. It was an OSHA violation and had people walking around and bouncing their heads off of things as they're staring down those little black tubes. Dope scopes. Wow, that's what they're called? Dope scopes. I'm getting that right. Dope scopes. Because, man, that's an apt name, I will just say. the winners are there. I'm not even going to try to pronounce them. I think that's Roy. It's really the rest of them are obvious. So the winners, if you could go see War Collar, they'll hook you. Have prizes, right?
They already got them.
Sweet. Congratulations. No, there's no prizes? They got them. This is well organized. Thank you. Thanks to War Collar for running their contest. Shmoocon Labs, am I doing this? Okay, I will do this. These are real stats. We had 47 access points. It actually takes a lot of work to cover this much space. One thing we really try to do is actually have like enterprise grade service on the floor. You know, if you hadn't made it down to labs, it's actually an impressive amount of hardware, impressive amount of work to have. You can go and self enroll to get WPA2 enterprise with certificates and the whole deal, which is something unique, right? Most enterprises, most of your companies don't have that ability, and here you can go and get online, and it's pretty amazing actually. So we've got good bandwidth. We've got a lot of a fair number of users. We had over 400 users this year, which is about a fifth of the con, which is pretty awesome. There's something in here about IPv6, and there's no stats. I think that's because IPv6 is a lie. So I'm an IPv6 conspiracy theorist. I'm not paying any attention to that goddamn thing. No. If you look, there's a Stargate in the back of the room. No, it's not. No. It is not going home with Bruce or Hardy. I will.
Are we starting the bidding early, are we?
I had to buy it last year just so it didn't come home. What? Oh, Blue Knight's here, for God's sake. We'll get to you in a minute. All right. Anyway, before we get done with Shmoocon Labs, we want to make sure we acknowledge, first of all, the attendees. Thanks to the attendees, and thanks to the lab staff for putting it on. It's awesome to be able to have a reliable network, to have network at the podium, at the streaming, for all your phones or whatever devices you brought. They did a great job. So thanks to all the labs folks. Optiv had a contest. All of these people won, I guess. Optiv apparently has a lot of money. that's pretty awesome. Yeah, exactly. That was all our profit.
I think they've already been delivered.
And they think they've been delivered. If not, you can...
They're somewhere. You know.
They're somewhere. We've answered the existential question of where's Optiv. They're somewhere. Cool. T-shirt charities. We raised, this is just non-final because we counted a couple hours ago, and this is the number, but we're still selling T-shirts and other stuff. So far, we've raised over $12,000 for various charities. And to that end, EFF's going to come up and say a few words.
I didn't actually
did they want to come up? You want to come up and say a few words?
Are you drunk enough to go up and say a few words?
Yeah. It's... Sorry, not to spring it on you. Just the HFC will come up and say a few words next, just so you know HFC. There you go. EFF, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Yeah, I don't want to keep it quick. Don't want to hold you here too long, but I want to say thank you so much for all of you who bought some T-shirts and contributed to EFF and those who came by the table to become members. We love coming back here and working with this community. So thank you. Thank you so much.
And a few words from HFC, question mark, somebody from HFC? All right, he's coming. Woo! HFC.
Howdy. So I'm back in the U.S. embracing my American heritage, as you can see, Northwest Arkansas, so.
Yeah.
I don't know how to answer that at all. I just got to just leave that one alone. Anyway, thank you guys so much for your support. It's been great. Those of you that are wondering, our Uganda programs are still running and supported by the hacker community. So you guys have just been awesome through the years. I've taken a couple months off to get my feet under me and spend time with my family. But my focus now that I'm back is to focus on HFC US and get people involved in their local communities because there's a lot of work we got to do right here at home. So thank you guys so much for your support through the years. It means a lot. Thank you, all the Shmoocon team. Bruce, Heidi, you guys are just amazing. Thanks for all the effort you put in. Sleepless nights. We love you guys.
Cool. Yeehaw!
Yeehaw! Are Gabe and Tycho here? Anyone? Child's play? Sorry. Wow, not a lot of... Anyway, no, nobody. No, that just landed. All right. I thought it was funny, too. So Child's Play obviously is not here, but we let's hear it for the money raised for Child's Play, about $4,000. So, G2 had a contest. They had three prizes to give away.
Apparently they did.
So, but if you haven't gotten them, they're over there. But anyway, thanks to G2 for sponsoring the contest this year as well. So HackForgers happened again. Anyway, you better start, just come up. Like, just start coming. There's a whole army of RIT people here. Like, half the con is RIT, as best I can tell. For, like, the fourth year, the finals of HackForgers turned into RIT versus Penn State. And I think historically the way that this went down is RIT won the video game side, but they couldn't get their shit together on the hacking side, and they got beat. Was it the opposite? Okay, they couldn't get their shit together. period. There, is that better, Haim?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I just want to make sure we're super clear on that. Because what I see here says Penn State, Mobile Disco, Team Zelda. I don't see any RIT on here. How long have you guys been playing this?
Since it was beginning, right?
Since we started in 2011? Yeah. And this is the first year that they won. So anyway, let's hear it for Team Sparsa. So they get three things. First of all, you get to you get to Stargate. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
You may get the Stargate. There's actually some discussion that you may not be able to come back unless you take it home. So first of all, we'd like to present you with the wrench that they have to get engraved and bring back. You have to get it engraved. We're not going to pay for it. You got to do it yourself. You get the dog tags to signify that you are winners of something. And they get to bypass the line next year and buy Shmoocon tickets without having to hit F5. So congratulations to Team Sparsa from RIT. It was, and let's hear it for Penn State, who let them win this year. Also, go Army. All right. Okay, now you can go. Okay.
Do you want to do that first?
Do what? Do you want to do the Stargate or Shmoocanography first? Shmoocanography it is! All right, Shmoocanography, come on up.
This is where I mess up again. There it is. Okay, wait. Play.
All right. All right, guys, so Shmoocanography, we had a number...
That's the coolest graphic ever.
Yeah, isn't it cool? This is Mike's sister who made it. So we had so we had 11 teams play, and a lot of people here getting to stage four. This graphic you see here is actually old, but the winners are three blind mice, and they've teamed up with Flowers by Irene. So if you guys want to come on up, meet Mike.
$500 cash.
Yes, thank you. So the people running our badge contest were sitting there playing your contest.
And they won.
I love that.
So yeah, they're going to get $500 sponsored by Praxis Engineering, some shirts, and they can keep one of the posters. Let me run through the stages real quick. So stage one, you'll notice there was a mirror sitting on one of the tables out there. If you look in the mirror, position your head just right, 70%, and smile, it'll actually show you a picture. There is an iPad behind that mirror. It'll show you something in there, what you see right here with the message. Moving on to stage two, we took a CD, light-scribed the message on the CD itself, put a label on top, and gave those out. A lot of people, you know, were looking at the contents. We put a whole bunch of files on there, but it was really just pulling off the label, and there you have it. One of the files on that CD was actually related to stage three. It was a threat letter. So let me just jump to the letter. The letter looked like this at the top, and it was in the PDF form. So if you actually just copy the text and paste it into Word, anything else, you'll see what's in the middle here. And anything that didn't copyright, so any of the weird symbols, was actually the letters of the message. That's all you had to do. And then if you go into the PDF itself and look where I messed up the code for the letters to copy and paste, that's where the code word is. So at the bottom, you can see. So if you just replace that, what the code word is, with /filter, you would fix the PDF, which somebody did and kind of made it worse for themselves for at least a little bit of time. All right, stage four. So there was a FM. We were broadcasting FM RDS to actually, it was one of the, Whiplash clip. But you actually look at the RDS to get the clue and the code word. Some teams got tricked up because there was a couple of letters that repeat, and it didn't like blip or anything. It just those two letters that repeated would stay on there twice as long. So once people got that, they moved on to stage five, which was just a PCAP capture. And right here, all you had to do is look for the beacon packets for Hydra. A lot of people got that. I started flipping the bits for the privacy bits, which was completely random. So, but really what you need to look at was the timestamp between the packets. So anything that was around 50 milliseconds difference, that was a zero. Anything above 350 was a one, and that was it. So we had a... there was somebody who they did the whole thing, right? Yeah. So we actually had a bonus stage was our shirts. So you'll notice that our shirts, right here has this background on the back. So if you complete the 2D barcode or this circular barcode, you can get your 1D barcode here. It's 1337. And if you just go to our site 1337, you will get a note saying you get a free shirt, but nobody got that. So, no free shirts. So if you put all the code words together, this is how they look. If you read down the columns, you actually get this. So once you figure this out, you realize that these are just weapons from Stark Industries. So wrapping this up, again, I want to thank Praxis Engineering. They really sponsored us. Without their help, it gets a little more difficult to play the game. Along with all these here, so Nick Bow Designs, that's the t-shirt. No Starch Press for all the, so all the contests, whoever beat each stage first got a $50 gift certificate to No Starch Press. So it was, they helped us out there. So overall, I want to thank Bruce, Heidi, and the whole Shmoo team, because really without their help, and we do need their help putting on this game, it's really hard for us to do. So if you want a t-shirt order, I'm going to let Mike handle that, so you can email us, because I will just fail. I will never order them. So you can, we can get the last year, the Zelda one, or this year if you're interested. That's it.
Cool. Thanks.
Thanks to the Shmoocanography team for doing that. Will and Mike do a great job.
Do you see those? Yeah, we see those.
It's not a chandelier.
No, it's much more expensive.
So the Shmoocanography team, they put a lot of effort into that contest, and they have for years, and it's really pretty fascinating. And I do have to say something about at least Will, who was just talking. So Will, I hired out of college, and he started working for me. And I had another guy named Will, so we had a fresh out Will, so we just called him Fresh. And he's a tenacious dude. Like, he gets a lot of stuff done. And I knew he was something special when he was restoring a car, and he said, hey, I just powder coated my engine block this weekend. And I'm like, cool, I didn't know you had a powder coating rig. I don't know if any of you have powder coated anything, but you cover it in this dust, and then you get it really hot, and then it sticks to it. And so I'm like, you have a powder coating rig? He's like, no, but I had a couple of ovens. I'm like, and he'd taken an oven, and he put it on his back, and he disabled all the safeties, and then he put the engine block inside after he coated it, and then put the other oven on top and disabled the safeties and set them both to broil. And I thought, this dude is awesome. So anyway, big thanks. They've been doing this for years. It's a lot of work. Appreciate everybody playing. Appreciate those guys putting it on. So thanks, folks. Lockpick Village is back again in fourth. What?
In fourth?
In fourth? Fourth, sorry. Fourth.
Do you want to do this? Do you want us to do this? It's right there.
What's right? Who are you
I'm
talking to?
Deviant.
Oh. Who? Oh, he's coming. It's all them. It's all them. Yay, Tool!
Thank you all for coming. We are the open organization of lockpickers. I hope you stopped by the Lockpick Village and either learned lockpicking for the first time or picked it up where you left off. If you were in there, you probably saw the gigantic big clock-like thing on the wall. That was our new electronic timed picking contest. We had a bunch of people compete in it. Some very fast opening times in the first round. The second round was a little bit more difficult, but we did get it down to three finalists. We had somebody gave their name as Kager, 55.1 seconds. That got them $25 in the tool store. Second place, Dennis D, 42 seconds, $50 in the tool store. And Matt, with a time of 23.2 seconds, got out-of-band ticket for next year. So come see us next year, learn picking locks, and see you next year. Thank you.
Thanks to Lockpick Village. People come over to our house, and you try to explain what they do, and you're like, cybersecurity is complicated, it's hard, or whatever, and then you're like, well, how about we just want to learn how to pick locks? You're like, yeah, that sounds way cooler, so then you teach people how to pick locks. And I certainly got my start understanding physical security from busting my wrists up on handcuffs and cutting myself out of zip ties and all that kind of crap in the Lockpick Village. So,
you go to the bedroom is your...
Yeah, busy. Thanks, Josh. Walked. Actually, it's funny. The one year, I think we were up at Sector, I was really getting into breaking out of the handcuffs. Like, you got to hit them really hard to break kind of like the secondary lock, and then you shim your way out of them to get out. And my wrists were just beat to shit. We're destroying chairs at this conference center. No offense, Brian. Sorry if you're here, but there were a few broken chairs. And the next day, I go to a client site, an early morning meeting, and my wrists are just chewed up. And the client, she asked me, she's like, what the hell happened to your wrist? I'm like, oh, I spent the weekend breaking out of handcuffs. And I didn't think it through. And like, and her response is, she got really wide-eyed. I'm like, what? Oh, no. It's not. Whatever you're thinking, it's not that, you know. It was at the Toronto Convention Center. It's totally okay. So Hack 5 has some gear that they donated that we're going to give away. They don't have a contest or anything, so I'm going to do something now to try to give it away. Is anyone wearing a Bow to My Firewall shirt?
Ooh. I have one in my suitcase.
That doesn't count then. Did anyone wear a Bow to My Firewall or have it with them here at the con?
I have one in my suitcase.
I saw someone roaming around earlier one. Oh, there's one hand. Sir, come on up. Come on.
Is he wearing it?
Now, you don't have to wear it right now. You just come forward. Just come forward.
He admitted to. Oh, but he's wearing Insecurity We Trust, yeah?
He is wearing an Insecurity We Trust shirt. Come on. Expeditiously. There we go. Wow. You really run well. So I'll make a deal with you. Don't take it. I will give you this Hack 5 kit if you bring that shirt to me next year and turn it in.
I will double the value for the copy for the shirt.
I'll take what's behind door number 3.
Door number 3? I'll give it to you anyway, so I appreciate it. Thanks, sir. Thank you to Hack 5. I'm not a fan of seeing myself on t-shirts, and one day we were walking through the Columbia Mall and some dude was wearing a Bow to My Firewall shirt, and I walked up to him and I just pulled $100 out of my pocket and I said, take your shirt off and give it to me. She was mortified. Don't! I was like, what?
That is our Uber story.
Yeah.
To be fair, I had those shirts printed without telling him.
Yeah, I had no idea. So. Pluralsight had a contest as well, a scavenger hunt. I'd like to thank everyone who played and thank Pluralsight. If you're a winner, in particular if you're a Pluralsight, if you don't already have your prize, stop by the booth immediately after closing to claim. I can read. All right. Shmoocon 2017 winners for
Wireless CTF.
Wireless CTF. Are they coming up to talk? No, they're not coming up. Okay, next. After this, we're going to do the goddamn Stargate.
Are we?
Yeah, because you're here. Might as well.
In the promise of being fast, Jack Tenna, nice job. We had a throwback to 14 years ago for the wireless war drive. He apparently hired someone to do the war drive with his team, and they ended up with 21,000 access points unique in the area in a day and a half. Yeah. So... he got the radios that we're using, the DMR radio, the Hack 5 Tetra, a Pwnplug R3, and two of the coins from this year. Second place, Red Zone, did an amazing job. They got a Nano and the Fox that we're using for this year. And then Root Acquired really kicked ass, and they ended up with a Nano and some stickers and some other stuff. We had some awesome sponsors. Thanks for having us back again. We love playing with you guys. Thanks.
Woo! Josh? Jack Tenna? Yeah.
If Josh is here, come up, please.
He's right there.
Jack Tenna.
Wrong Josh. Wrong Josh.
Run!
He is. Like, he's actually running. Like, versus the other guy. I don't know. He's like Mario.
Or if he'll get shot.
Thank you.
All right.
Bye.
Wow. I got odd. All right. So we're going to auction off the Stargate. But there's... Oh, right. That kid cost me a lot of money last year.
Isn't that child abuse?
Yeah, so you're not happening. Anyway, I'm going to turn it over. So last year, the money proceeds went to World Bike Relief. This year, the proceeds will go to HFC. Johnny's Back in Country will donate the money to HFC. So for those that don't know the lineage of what's going on here, this was a prop one year from the powder coating people from Shmoogonography, right? So this is a Shmoogonography thing, and like there's stuff behind the red, and you could see it, and whatever. And at the end, they thought, wouldn't it be great to auction this off? And we're like,
I think it was, wouldn't it be great to send it home?
Oh, and send it home, right. So I end up with this thing in our basement, in like finished basement, and I had nowhere to store it, and it lived in this little narrow hallway that we had for an entire year. Like, it came home, and I put it there when we unloaded the truck, and then I left it there, and it collected like cat hair, and there's like, you know, mice poop around it, and I'm like, oh my God, and like, there was not mice, we didn't have mice at that house. So anyway, but it, there was a lot of cat hair. So it sat there, and every dad walked past it like, God, I should do something with this. And we waited a whole year, and it came back to Shmoocon, because I'm like, screw this thing, we're going to give it away. And then it turned into like an auction thing that you had to take home, because it's gigantic, right? It's a goddamn Stargate. So we started auctioning it off, and now it's like the plague, where you get it, and you have it for like a year, and then you bring it back, and someone else gets the plague. So... And Josh has been kind enough to auction this thing off. He's going to do this in an expeditious fashion, and so we don't drag this out for 20 minutes. But first,
I have presents.
There are presents now involved in the Stargate. There's like an ecosystem of things that are happening. So
I did a thing, and I believe so far the Stargate has been owned by yourself.
Oh. It was the photo booth at my wedding.
It was the photo booth at his wedding, yeah.
My dear friend Rick here took it home last year, and I believe we have taken it home twice, thanks, Blue Knight. So I went and bought mini Stargate replicas.
That's awesome. Oh my God.
And Blue Knight,
yeah.
Even though I really don't want to hand this to you... That one's for you.
Blue Knight started the tradition of buying it for someone else. So. Oh! The Stargate doesn't like competition from other Stargates. Fuck that other Stargate. Ah! Oh, it's.
Little flexible.
It's totally okay. It still works. So even when you've gotten rid of the Stargate, you still have a Stargate. So it really is like the plague. All right, while they're doing that, Josh is going to auction this thing off.
Well, so first off, apparently this is to remind you that if you send it home with Heidi again, this is what a certain bodily part will look like. But first, before we auction it, I have to request the owner of it actually give it up for auction.
I was a little busy, so I'm donating this to HFC now.
And I didn't want Bruce to take it.
Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, and believe me, I mean that. We have two items that literally got handed to me, and the person ran away, so I didn't see who they were. So we've got to auction them off. And then I have a suggestion. Who won?
Mike and shit goes right off the rails.
But everybody loves it. Who won Hack Fortress?
RIT.
I think RIT is a great place, don't you?
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you that it costs money to ship something like this, because it's big, it's heavy, it's expensive. He had to strap it to his hatchback to get it here. And, yeah, I'm actually not joking. Did it?
Yeah, I just couldn't have any passengers.
It's okay, he's antisocial. So... Wait, seriously? Okay, so who's going to give me $100 and we're going to keep going to send this to RIT?
Oh, God.
Okay, and I've got another $100 from you, Ruin. Who else is going to give me $100? Come on, I've got one back there. Who else is going to be $100 to send this to RIT? Stand up. Stand up if you're going to give me $100. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. I got one over there. Stand up if you're going to give me $100. Stand up. Come on, I'm in for $100. Come on, stand up. Ladies and gentlemen of RIT, can we guarantee that it will go outside of Professor Sanders' office? Good. I need somebody else to stand up. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Bring them up.
Come on up here, guys. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I want to see 10 people standing up here. What's that? No. But I'll take it. I'm not stupid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Who's one more? 10. We're done. Ladies and gentlemen. Was that expeditious enough? We've got 11.
No, right here.
Okay, I've got
87 bucks.
Fine. If you hit the bathroom, never mind. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. $1,000 or $1,187, whatever. to get this to RIT and put it outside of Professor Sanders' office. Would anybody like a moose mug, or can I get, say, $30 from somebody to give this to Heidi?
Right here.
50 for Heidi. 50 for Heidi. Done.
All right, $1,200 raised for HFC and a little bit of shenanigans. Thanks very much. Heim, we expect pitchers. All right, excellent. Give it to him. There we go. Make it rain.
Make it rain for the Scariate.
And just one more announcement for the RIT folks. You are being asked to, after all of this is over, gather in the back for your annual photo.
Yes. And the same applies... With a Stargate, yeah. So RIT, PSA, they're going to meet in the back. Also for PCT, Penn College of Technology represent. Woo! They're the closest thing I have to a degree, and that's because I'm on like an advisory board, so I'm going to call that like I go to college. And you're going to meet in the back, not at RIT section. You're going to get your picture taken too. So
I can infiltrate.
I'll pretend I'm a student. Hi there, kids. Whoa. I love that picture with Steve Buscemi, whatever the hell movie that's from. He's like, Buscemi? Are you really going to give me shit about pronouncing that guy's name wrong? Wow. Okay, fair. King and Union had a contest as well. Winner gets tickets to see...
No idea what that is.
Diesto. That's awesome. That's pretty cool, actually. Scott's less than excited about that. Anyway, Michael, they will contact you and send the ticks. Hey there, kids. All right, Fire Talks.
What are these?
What are what?
Nothing.
Okay.
Over and Johnny.
Grex. He's coming. Grex is going to do his thing. Johnny, T-shirt, give it out. Better not break anything. We won't. All right. It's bodies, man. Like, I'm worried about bodies. It's a secondary effect. Go back, go, yeah, but spread out. Spread out.
No throwing. No.
Please don't throw them very far. Thank you. Oh my God, this is making me nervous. Yeah. Yeah. What do you got, VGA or? Hey, do we have a lightning adapter? Oh, you do. Oh, okay. There. Yeah.
I told him be calm.
Be calm.
All right, count it down. 3, 2, 1.
Wow, this got chaotic. This is what HFC does, man. It brings the old school chaos back. Grex is going to present on Fire Talks. Big thanks to Grex for organizing Fire Talks and making it happen again this year. Go, Grex. He's totally not freaking out trying to plug this thing in. He just tried to put it in the Ethernet slot. Didn't work. Can you guys see anything? Can you guys see anything on the screen? Yay. Not really. Is it just the background? Okay, so you can't see it?
Everybody can see it.
Yeah, I know. It was a joke. What's up, everybody?
All right, so I learned something useful at Shmoocon, and you guys have to, at Shmoocon Fire Talks, and you have to figure out what that is. So who attended Fire Talks? Who really attended Fire Talks? Everybody's supposed to put their hand up, right? So we had lots of fun at Fire Talks this year. So for those that don't know, Fire Talks are just these like little 15-minute talks that, you know, so you can fluff or you can go through. Yeah, you definitely want to go to Fire Talks next year. But you basically have 15 minutes to, you know, give a full-length talk, and so you can cut out all the intro stuff and just jump right into the main content. So that's the whole part of that. So I am getting the feeling that Fire Talks are running a little long. This is the second year in the row. We've had some problems. The judges, you know, need to take bathroom breaks. So this is the second year this has happened. So. She was very quick, though, so. I know. All right. All right, sorry about it. All right, so to just kind of go through this. Yeah, I was a little late. All right, okay, let's hurry up and go through this and please stop yelling at me. All right, so third place, I don't think nobody knew this, so this is Brandon O'Connor. He gave a talk on You Can Do the Thing. Kind of like, so if he wants to come up and grab a blank piece of paper from me, come on up. Hey. All right. See, I just referred to this as the potato talk. So that's kind of what I learned about it. So he's O'Reilly is sponsoring the prize for that, $125. So the only thing to really plug there is they have their conference coming up in October. CFP is coming up soon. It's focused on defense, so it's a great conference. I went last year. Check it out. So second place was Jason Blanchard. So Rendition Sec was the sponsor for this, $250. Amazon gift certificate. So the interesting thing was that this was the first year that, you know, the Rendition Sec sponsor, who is Malware Jake, for those that know him, wasn't able to make it this year because of weather. So the two of the Fire Talk presenters, Travis and Jason, got to present in the Belay It track on Saturday. So thanks, Heidi. And then first place was Travis. Travis Goodspeed. I don't know if he's here. All right. So this is... So the prize was from Cyber Defense Technologies. So definitely thank them for sponsoring this. It's $500. What else? Oh, and as usual, Travis has donated his amount to Hackers for Charity. So thanks, Travis. And then... I like literally went and tried to find the most embarrassing pictures. I was trying to find one of
20 years old.
I was trying to find one of Katie doing like karaoke or something, which is pretty close. All right. All right. So I just want to thank the judges, the celebrity judges this year. So Space Rogue and Chemo. And I also want to thank Shmoocon just for hosting this awesome event and for supporting Fire Talks this entire year. This year was a little different because they actually made it an official Shmoocon event, so thanks Heidi and Bruce. And I also want to thank the volunteers and the staff of all Shmoocon, and then just the attendees, not only that attended Shmoocon, but the Fire Talks. You know, it wouldn't be anything without you. So in conclusion, thanks and see you next year.
Thanks, Grex. Can you guys still see it? No. It was jeez. It's broken. It's green! Yay, reboot. Reboot. So, wow, any Fairly Odd Parents fans in here? Reboot. No, anyone? Wow, okay, sorry. Weird Nickelodeon cartoon fetish thing going on. Actually, I was somewhere that I was talking to a woman who had like every old school Nick cartoon, like Cat Dog and all that, tattooed like all the way down her arm. It was amazing artwork, and it was all like that weird mid 90s Nick cartoon stuff. I'm like, that was crazy. Like, what was your childhood like? Like, I mean. Okay, so amateur radio exams, our first year doing this. 17 people got a license, so we got 15 new technicians. So these are brand new ham radio operators, and now two people with general licenses. So that is awesome. This is becoming a regular thing at more and more events, which is great. And it's thanks to the folks that what?
Go ahead.
What? Nothing. You punched me in the middle of saying it, and I thought I was doing it wrong.
Sorry.
We're not thanking you for putting this on. It's totally not cool. Like, yeah, fuck. Oh wow! Like, I actually got the bird. That was great. thanks to Adam and Lindsay for putting this on. Thanks very much. This is very awesome that you guys do this. And we'd love to see more people do this next year. Honestly, if you've taken like high school level physics, you can crash study for the technician exam in a pretty short period of time, get your license, and start to explore the awesomeness that is ham radio. So if you haven't taken physics? Oh, but yeehaw! All right, I don't even know what to say. Like, cat's like... sponsor contest, Airstone, Bobby won the Rubik's Challenge, my son, so I can at least get a shout out for that. Like, life skills, Bobby, good job. If anybody needs a Rubikologist for their data center, he can do it for you. The rest of the winners are there. Raspberry Pis for everyone. They went full Oprah on this. And Raspberry Pis for you and for you. So thanks to Airstone for all the Raspberry Pis. Ted's here shooting videos. Again, thanks. Yay, Ted. Appreciate it. So it's a big deal for Ted to come out here, and if I don't know if you've noticed, but not a lot of people have DVD drives anymore. So Ted's still selling DVDs. Honestly, anything you can do to help Ted out, buy some DVDs, just hook him up with some cash, whatever. He appreciates it. He's a big part of the community. He's helped us out for years recording this stuff. And from the very beginning, he's given us all this content for free to do whatever we want. We put it on the Internet Archive. So, you know, you can stream it for free. There's no advertising associated with it. And, you know, the fact that from day one, he said, this is your stuff. You get to do whatever you want with it. That's a big deal for a videographer, right? And he gets paid, but not a ton. So, you know, whatever you can do to help Ted out, he would appreciate it. We appreciate it. And we appreciate his years that he's been coming here and helping us out. So thank you very much, Ted. The MIL Corporation had a prize, an Xbox One with Battlefield 1. Battlefield, the game where you get shot as soon as you spawn. Right, exactly. God damn it. Like, I'll play it for like 5 minutes. I'm like running after a tank, and I'm like, this is, damn it. And then do it again, run after the tank. fuck that game. So, yeah, thank you, Michelle. I'm like, yeah. Call of Duty is way better. So I'm going. They have the prizes. Ernest Wong, are you here? Are you here? Okay, we have notes. Oh,
I don't know how to see notes.
We're gonna go like this. The alternate one, Michael Rutter, are you here? Oh, he's here.
No, that's them.
Oh, that's them. I'm like, you already got your prize. I was so confused. Is Michael Rutter here? 3, 2, what? Okay, what's your name?
He's like Michael Rutter.
What? Michael Rudden? That sounds like you then. Over there, go that way. Okay. That person has a name suspiciously close to mine. That was almost a hash collision, but not quite, right? Shmoo. Okay. All right. Getting toward the end, so big breath and we'll finish this thing out. We mentioned most of this already, but we wanted to thank all the event organizers, all the time and energy. I mean, we do a little bit as an organization to help them out for the most part. These folks bring their own kit, they invest their own time, they invest their own money to make Shmoocon bigger, better, meaner, better, to allow you to have more things to do and make it even cooler. So big thanks to everybody that organized events here at Shmoocon this year. This is way awesome. Don't troll me like that! Holy shit. anyway, and also, thanks to our sponsors. You go to big trade shows and sponsors stand there and hand you little pieces of swag and try to recruit you and whatever, and it's kind of amusing and everything. But, you know, these sponsors are really engaged. They're giving out cool prizes. They're putting in a lot of time and energy into the contest. And, you know, they may be employees of their employer or whatever, by definition of the name employee and employer. But... Syntactical humor is the best humor. So, yeah. Woohoo! But again, thanks to all our sponsors and all the hard work that they put in too. So. Thanks for the speakers. Lots of first-time speakers, first-time Shmoocon speakers. I know it can be intimidating. You know, it's especially the first time we get on stage. I remember the first time I got up on stage, I thought people were going to tell me I was full of shit. After the third or fourth time, and nobody did, and that's when I started making it up. So, just so you know, that's about how long you have before you can just totally bullshit, and people are like, oh, that's awesome. So thank you to the speakers. Also, thank you to the attendees for showing up. It seems like an odd thing to do, but honestly, not showing up part, but thanking you. You know, this event is for you all. It's for the community. It's for the people who can watch online during the event or after the event and that kind of thing. We're trying to make the world a little bit better, and you showing up helps do that. So, yes?
This is the kind of long part, but we're going to go through it because these guys are amazing. So you've got all these maroon shirts at the front. Maybe some of them changed. I don't know. So I'm going to call out you by department. If that's you, just come stand up front because we're going to get you a big old round of applause. So security team, these are the guys guarding the doors. They're the ones watching the party. They're the ones helping you when you need the help the most. All right, next up, our program selection team is large. They read all those papers that you guys send in. Program selection, if you are in the room, come up to the front. Our network and lab staff, they provide us the internets, usually. And just a shout out, too, to any of our labs attendees still in the audience who helped get our network up and running. Okay, our registration staff, please come down to the front. These guys checked in, as we've already said, one person every 3 seconds on Friday. They were slammed the entire time this year. You guys were awesome. Awesome, awesome. They also make sure that I get fed, so I like them very much. AV support, that's Bob and Jim, who are around here somewhere. These guys work really hard. If you're a speaker, you've seen at least one of them, maybe even both of them. Taping team, stand up, because some of you can't come to the front, I know. These guys are taping all the talks. They're helping Ted. Again, an amazing team. Streaming, for all you folks at home, these are your favorite people in the world. They are making sure that that this is going there and that you're seeing it now. All right, we've got a press request team who vets all the press that are here at the con. They're like, yay, go us! We said yes to that email. And my party team. Did you guys have fun last night at the party? Yeah. I'm not kidding. It's basically three people, and they make it happen every single year. All right. I've got all the people who helped out doing speaker introductions, and some of these, you know, roles overlap. You can raise your hand and say, yeah, I did that too. That's cool. I'm good with that. So I've got my proctors, the guys who are doing introductions for us all week long. All right, we've got Fire Talks. That was Grex. He was up here earlier. We've got our Hack Fortress team. You've heard a little bit about them already today, but that's a big team. They work really hard. They're sitting in the back and not moving, but you can at least wave. Everybody wave. Hi, Hack Fortress. These guys are so cool. For ever since we moved the party on site, they also man that door at that party for me every year. So it's just, I love you guys. All right, we've got, this is kind of me and Kim, really, but I've got a paper program creation. You know, we just work really hard. She's not here, I don't think, but Jim, thank your wife for us. She's awesome. I've got a lot of people who work with me behind the scenes doing things. Prior to the con, Frank helps me out, puts all the stuff on the website. Todd's helping us answer emails. We've got ticket sales, which is, you know, David, Ben. I don't even know where you guys are. And it's just crazy. I've got one amazing runner this year. And if I've missed anybody, I'm so sorry. But you guys, this is Shmoocon right here. Please thank them. Oh, did I forget photography? I said I was going to forget something. Can I get my photographers up here, too? Thank you. I am so sorry, you guys. Watch this. See, it was always there. I like to edit on the fly. All right. One last thing. Can I do the last slide?
And one last thing before we get to the last thing. I'd like to big thank to Heidi for all the work that she does all year round. And nobody else is thinking about Shmoocon. She's thinking about Shmoocon and making it happen. So. Boy. You all listened to her, right? Like, you all, whoop, everyone just sat down. It got silent. It was pretty funny. And I guess... Yeah. So, a lot of ways to take that, actually. Like, 20 years ago, she was tired of me. And I guess the big news is Shmoocon 2018 will be January 19th to 21st, right back here.
Right here. All right, go home.